Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Hitch, the first year of music. My name is Feroz and I'm the director.
I'm James. I'm the assistant director. Fire or emergency. There are two exits down here and two exits up there, as well as one exit in the back down here. We also want to ask you guys to silence your cell phones. It can be really distracting during the show. But you are allowed to take videos or photos, just make sure your flash is off.
What makes the first year music look truly special is the fact that everything, from the sets to the music to the script to the directing, are all controlled and executed by first year students. We really hope you will find your place and find home within the world of Hitch, the first year musical. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
And now, by the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
And I'm Pepper, and we're here to put some pep in your step. Coming up today, is my roommate Fish a psychic? And later on, students under the new tax plan may face crippling debt.
Thanks again for listening to RBFM 21, the only college radio not monitored by the school.
Because the school doesn't know about it. It's Monday, August 14th, 2017. National Wiffleball Day, National Creamsicle Day, and National Financial Awareness Day. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Woo!
Singing. Thank you. Complicate things because he'd have to be okay cutting everything off after graduation.
Well, that
that's gonna be hard. What guy do we know that would absolutely never fall for a girl like you?
Okay, which of the following
be ones... civil union.
Nice. That's right.
Oh, it's true.
I think I remember you telling me that.
Well, yeah, I am. But
an apartment? How did you get off campus housing? You're not seen.
You can if you're married or getting married. Drew and I are officially engaged, so I just explained the situation on the housing forum and they let us off campus. I'm sorry, Angie. I thought I'd told you.
It's fine, really. I get it. I mean, getting married makes sense.
You know I'm always here for you, right, Angie? The both of you.
Of course. Just like I'll be here for the both of you.
Well, ideally you'll be in law school. Friendship is a place that knows no bounds.
You can count on us, Angie.
Things are happening way too fast for me.
Fast? Well, we have been together 10 months, and it's not as if we're the ones getting married. You're ashamed of me.
No, I'm not. I'm not ashamed of you. I promise. I just wish we could keep things simple. No complications.
I wasn't aware there are any complications.
There aren't. Let's keep it that way.
Oh! I just don't get it. Well, 1 minute we're fine and we're kidding around and everything is great, and the next minute it just blows up. Oh! Why does it have to be so... And then I come, and then he goes... Oh, no!
You know what?
What?
You're getting tears on my favorite pillow. Oh, no. Good, because you shouldn't be.
Listen. Don't you worry.
I'm not worried.
Take a seat. Take a breath. Slow your hurry. Can't stand all your fast bumping. You're don't it make your head hurt? Don't it make your eyesight blurry? You got different ways than I. You're looking kind of crazy, but I'll try.
You'll
yes.
I'll
yes.
Teach you how to decompress. I take out my phone, now that I'm grown, time is mine to take and mine to own. I just sit and scroll. I'm never in trouble when I'm in my bubble. Yeah. Now I have calligraphy accounts on Instagram.
Wait, you don't have any dreams. No ambitions.
So when I was 13, I really wanted to be a fortune cookie writer. You know, that you get on cookies in Chinese restaurants. But then I got this one fortune that said,
your endeavors are in vain. Try something new.
Which I figured meant,
your dreams suck, dumbass.
So I realized that that probably wasn't the right path for me. But did I worry?
He worried.
Not at all. Because we sit and scroll. I'm never in trouble when I'm in my bubble. My team control. Don't you worry about boys.
Boys.
Don't you worry about cash.
Ouch.
Don't take your mind off of Steven Jobs and money. Give it away to old Steve Jobs' husband.
I feel nothing.
Whether you're a they, a miss, or a mister, constrained as long as by sin.
Angie, are you cold?
Benjamin Newton, my best, most wonderful friend, light of my life, fruit of my bloom.
Of what we'd save if you'd wed me today.
Sure, son. A. Ron Burr.
I know who Aaron Boone is. I just can't believe that's how you see me.
He's more of an Eliza. He was always just so
helpless.
Eliza!
Look,
the FAFSA is self-reported, which means the government doesn't actually get involved. So, you don't have to sign the marriage certificate or actually get married. And they're not gonna check. No one will ever know.
No one will ever know. No one will ever know. Including Angie.
Including Angie. Which is why we can do this. Easy.
Easy.
Problem solved.
Problem.
Don't worry about her. She'll be fine. Besides, it's not your job to pay for your friend's grad school. What she's asking of you is honestly kind of ridiculous. Trust your gut. Do the right thing. I know you always do.
I really hope you're right.
Woo!
Pissed off people.
I just said that.
Angie, I need to talk to you about a little marriage.
Who are you?
I'm Lola.
Lola?
Yes, I'm Lola. How do you not know my name?
Look, how long have you been standing there?
Long enough to write a little marriage scam.
Marriage scam? No, that's just nuts.
Angie, I need to talk to you about a little marriage scam.
Oh, my God.
Very loudly. A lot. These are the kind of things I hear in here. Oh, this is the first fake marriage I've ever
heard. Fake marriage? No. You must have misheard us.
Obviously.
Clearly.
Ben wasn't saying anything about a fake marriage scam.
Nope.
He was talking about...
Yes.
Tell us, Ben. What were you saying? I'd love to know.
Fake marriage scam? No. What I was talking about was a miscarriage. Clam.
Fire, 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 fire,
say, to get a better education, to be able to study what I want without people judging me. Do you know what the primary study career path of Manchester Capitolians is? It's evolutionary biology of the hippo brain, which is our state animal. I do not spend my life being a hippo dog.
You mean you don't want to be a Hippocratic hippocampus major? Not to be hypocritical.
It says here there are some other ways that you can get citizenship. You could stay for 5 years and take the test.
Not quick enough.
Find a birth certificate proving you were born.
Not possible.
You're guaranteed citizenship if you serve in the military. If you die during combat.
Not fire. So it seems I still need to stay.
Commitment, if you know what I mean. ring.
We'll pay the price up front.
All right.
Apparently. What's your charge?
20 bucks.
You've got yourself a deal.
Oh, this is so exciting.
same last name?
Thank you.
Person two, second person?
Okay, now sign here and here. And now by the power of SPD, by becoming ordained minister .com, I now pronounce your husband and wife. Next!
Okay, I need to talk to you. Wait, what is this?
Please read the lines. Okay.
Angie, what in Sonia Sotomayor's name do you think you're doing?
People, that'll be $70.
Oh, how generous of you. You call this helping them.
I am helping them. I'm saving them thousands of dollars. Honestly, compared to that, $70 is a steal.
Okay. It was one thing to help Lola get out of channel, whatever it is, but this is getting extreme. You are getting way too out of hand.
What are you talking about?
Stop being so thick!
Stop being so thick?
Thick-headed, I meant.
I'm not thick-headed, I'm thick-skinned. Maybe you just need to toughen up and not be so afraid.
Well,
it'll only be a moment, sir.
Yeah, a moment before I shut this down. Get out of here, people. It is over. It is over.
What are you doing?
Customer service.
I need this money. You don't understand. I am not talking academic probation. I am talking years in federal prison. You won't be able to use your money behind bars.
You just don't get it, do you? You can afford to get whatever you want, whenever you want it.
That is not what I'm saying. I'm just trying to help you.
And I'm just trying to help them.
And you are only hurting yourself. You are being a complete idiot.
Excuse me? What kind of friend says something like that?
You know what?
You have everything. Everyone knows you're getting into whatever law school. You have never had to worry about money. You have someone who loves you. You have a roommate who you can talk to whenever. And what do I have? Tell me, what do I have?
I thought you didn't care about those things.
Well, I thought I had supportive friends.
Angie,
I guess we were both wrong.
Hey, you've reached Ellie and Drew. We're not in right now, but if you leave us a message, we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Drew would be much cuter if we both said it at the same time.
Oh, Angie.
Okay. I have this plan.
more time. Something bigger than either of us.
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 Oh!
But technically, legally, the marriage was totally legitimate. All of them were. I'm so sorry about earlier. You were right. I was just.
I don't apologize.
No, I should.
No, really shouldn't be saying.
You were always there with me, and I was just not.
I have to tell you. I never signed an IRS certificate.
What?
I never signed it. All the FAFSA.
I don't understand.
Angie, I am so, so sorry.
Should I leave you two alone?
But I was granted free tuition.
The FAFSA is self-reported, which means that the government doesn't get involved. Which means that I didn't have to sign the marriage certificate and the government wouldn't check. I thought they wouldn't check. I'm so, so sorry. Angie?
And you just didn't tell me?
I wanted to. I tried to.
You tried? We got the form in September. That was 5 months ago. You could have told me.
Yeah, but Stephen said that.
Stephen said. Do you have any idea what you've done? Oh my God. Oh my God, how could you do this to me? I'm gonna be sick. What are you even doing here? Just go back to Stephen since he seems to control your entire life.
Actually, we broke up.
What?
He cheated on me.
Hey guys, look what I found. Trip I took when I was younger. We went to Fanta Cheddar Whip to the Capitol.
Wait, you've been
been to Fanchon with Jimmy Gaffigan?
Oh yeah, it's a lovely place. I hated the food there though. The only way my mom could get me to go is by packing me a week's worth of cereal. Wait. Jordan.
Yes. It's you. It was always you.
So maybe you're the one for me. Perhaps you've always been. I'm so glad that I found you in this crazy world where I guess it's love.
Excuse me!
Yes.
came up here to give me a piece of his mind and I'll stop it!
And you and me. You and me. Oh, I can't believe I've been so ugly.
Stephen, I told Drew. Yes, we're done, but you know what? So are you and I.
Today's definition, arraignment.
An arraignment means the action of arraigning somebody in court.
But what does that mean, Piper?
Well, I'll tell you. Basically, when you do something bad, you might not have known it was so bad until the cop shows up at your door.
Or maybe you did. Either way, you're getting arraigned.
You'll head on down to court. There's going to be a clerk who records everything that happens and administers the oath.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
A bailiff who says, order, order.
Order, order! A pizza for dinner tonight, sweetie?
A judge who's basically king of the court.
You better kiss my ass or I'll send you to jail.
And any friends and family you might want to bring along. Because what else are friends and family for than to witness your undies grave?
Then you'll enter with your defense attorney. There'll be introductions.
Wait, where's...
state her full name.
Angela Caroline Lane.
Thank you, Ms. Lane. Do you have a defense attorney present?
I do not have a defense attorney with me, Your Honor.
Is that so?
What?
No attorney.
That is so. I was unable to bring a defense attorney with me today.
No, she wasn't.
Excuse me?
Your Honor, I will be serving as Angie Lane's defense attorney today.
Bet.
Hey, thick skin, how have you been? You look a little strange. Has someone popped you with a pin? Deflated your defenses again. And hey, thick skin, how's it been to be so unaware? You're not perfect, but you worth it. Can't you see me here? It looks like something's happened here, but we won't ever say. It's our secret, and we'll keep it clean up anyways. Cover it tight, put it in a box. Wrap it up and touch it in a big padlock. Throw it in a safe, on the bubble lake. Don't forget you ever made that little mistake.
What are you doing?
Save your ass, your friends.
All my friends are dead. Just that I'm guilty.
These days when you fall on your own face, it's not the end. You'll pull through, I promise you. You've got a friend.
Thank you.
Of course.
Tear down my heart!
of the school's founder. Ben got into grad school early, of course. Harvard Law School.
Transformative.
Jay had spent the year studying abroad and trying to whip into the Capitolia with Lola, who's running her own cereal business and is studying sociology. Jay, on the other hand, is studying hippo psychology. He's currently researching what hippos do all day.
They don't just sit and roll.
And after his parents discovered his newfound passion in life, they decided to give him back his inheritance. And even though their marriage was deemed illegitimate, Jay and Lola decided to stick it out. And, well, eventually... Woo! Probably because it's the only book in all of existence that uses its name. After that, with the help of the internet, it made its way around the world, and somehow Columbia University got rid of it. Now I have a full ride.
And a best-selling novel.
Things are definitely turning around for the better.
For us, too. Thanks to your story that we covered live, our ratings are through the roof! That's right, folks. It's 2019, and you're listening to National Public Radio with Piper and...
Let's go!
So tell us, how was the wedding?
The wedding? The wedding's today, actually.
Do you have a special date?
I'm going with the best man, Ben, as friends.
The best man indeed. Well, we wish you a wonderful wedding. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
So, there's a few thank yous.
Yes, we have a couple people who we wanted to thank.
So we'd like to call up Tom Morgan and Liz D for... From day one, I actually met with Liz and got her like advice and like way back in September, and she's been like incredible and so pivotal, and I can say the same about Tom in so many ways, and just endless things to both of you. And thank you, and we
have sort of personal stuff, but we just wanted to give a quick shout out to our incredible director. Incredibly supportive and creative team.